Hello and welcome back to Gizmo Guru. This here is the Sony Vaio Pro 13, and as you can see, it's a pretty little laptop. It's also light. Despite having a 13-inch screen, the whole laptop with the battery in place just weighs 1.06 kilos. And the sleek shape means that you can easily slip into your bag and just forget about it. Now, in terms of specifications, it's pretty solid too. There's a 4th gen Intel i5 processor that's running at 1.6 GHz, and it's got 4GB of RAM as well. Coupled with the size and weight, that makes it a really nice business laptop, something that can be used comfortably and reliably to get a lot of work done while you're on the go. My only real complaint with this machine is the price. Sony wants ₹74,990 for this version, and there's a model with more storage and an i7 CPU that's priced at 1,10,000. That is steep, and so is this. There aren't too many 4th gen laptops to compare it with in terms of price right away, but you can get a laptop that happily handles the same kind of usage for around ₹30,000 less, so that's a big premium for portability and, let's admit it, style. Now, the obvious comparison when you look at this machine is the MacBook Air, which is almost the same price, almost the same dimensions, and pretty similar hardware too. Sony does come ahead on all counts though, and full marks to them for going their own way in terms of design. Like it or not, you are not going to confuse this machine for a MacBook Air, and that is not something you can say for every Ultrabook out there. Personally, I like the look a lot, and the same is true for the build quality. You do notice just a little bit of flex when you are handling the lid, but otherwise it feels great. And also once you open it, you'll notice a nice and large keyboard. The keys are well spaced and individually lit. The trackpad is decent, but I do prefer the Air for this. It feels better somehow, it's hard to describe. The major drawback then with this machine, aside from the price, is the limited number of ports on the side, and of course it's using integrated graphics. That means that the machine's usage will be limited to work for the most part, and that means you're paying a premium to basically use Excel. Don't compare it to a dedicated gaming machine, not even one that costs the same amount of money. That's it for this week. Thanks for watching.